The Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources, or BFAR, says it is ready to cooperate with the Office of the Ombudsman's investigation on the delayed implementation of a ban on imported fish. BFAR says they will explain how they implement the Fisheries Administrative Order No. 195, which bans the sale of imported fish in the Philippines. The ombudsman ordered the probe after news reports came about imported fish like pink salmon and pompano are being sold in local markets.
Galang natin itong sasagutin at ibibigay natin ang mga necessary reports para sagutin itong inquiry ng ombudsman sa atin. Lately, saturated na talaga yung mga unauthorized imported frozen fish sa ating mga merkado. At the bottom line of this, kaya tayo nag-intensify, is really to protect the industry. Kailangan nating gumawa ng hakbang para bigyan ng proteksyon ang ating local fisher folk.
The recent spike in the prices of red onions in various markets has prompted government to review the country's supply of the product. The Department of Agriculture says it's coordinating with the Bureau of Plant Industry to determine the possible reasons behind the price hike. It has also asked the Bureau to review their inventories and cold storage facilities. The agency adds government is still not considering importing red onions. This comes as red onions are found to be sold as much as 300 pesos per kilo.
Sabi po nila ay meron po silang harvest ng Disyembre. Yung itinitingnan natin kung gaano kalaki ang kanilang volume na i-harvest dahil ito po ay makakatulong sa pagdagdag ng ating supply. Hopefully within the week we will have an inventory situation and that will definitely help pagdating po sa ating supply situation.
As problems surrounding the agriculture sector persist, Senator Bongo believes it's high time for President Marcos to appoint an agriculture chief. He says doing so would help the administration hit its goal of ensuring food security. Executive Secretary Lucas Garcimin earlier said Marcos is seriously considering appointing someone to lead the agriculture department, which the president currently heads.
Ako naman, pabor ako na magkaroon na talaga ng isang permanent na agriculture secretary because of the urgent needs po ng ating bayan, lalong-lalo na po sa food production at itong food security na may nakatutok po sa departamento. Bagamat nakatutok naman po ang ating mahal na Pangulong Marcos sa departamento, iba po yung talagang meron siyang alter ego as a cabinet secretary na nakatutok bilang full-fledged na cabinet secretary sa Department of Agriculture.
House Speaker Martin Romualdez files a bill seeking to create a sovereign wealth fund dubbed the Maharlika Investment Fund. Under the bill's explanatory note, SWFs are defined as state-owned investment funds, typically financed by a country's surplus revenues or reserves. The government invests these funds in both financial and real assets to promote economic development. The measure aims to give government financial institutions the opportunity to undertake investments to secure the country's long-term financial health. It would also create the Maharlika Investments Corporation. Romualdez said the bill is necessary to maintain the momentum of the country's growing economy. He said Singapore's SWF became a tool for the city-state to manage its foreign reserves, while Indonesia attracted foreign investors through its version of the fund.
The Philippine Environment Secretary urges the private sector to help address the impacts of climate change. Maria Antonia Yulo Loizaga spoke at a sustainability forum where she cited recent UN reports that warn the world could breach the climate benchmark of 1.5 degrees Celsius. Yulo Loizaga said the reports stressed the need for adaptation financing to avoid the harmful effects of climate change. The secretary also urged the private sector to help create a so-called national risk register that will serve as basis to determine gaps in development plans.
Even if the likelihood is high that we will miss what we promised to do by 2030, we must urgently establish shared values, synergies, commitment, and collaboration in order to avoid, minimize, mitigate, or compensate to address the impacts of climate change.